Bismillah
ar-Rahman.
Welcome back to the countdown. Inshallah, we continue with these reminders. You may have noticed by now I'm trying to take advantage of the so many sunny days that we have here in Toronto.
Yesterday, by mistake, we mentioned welcome back to the lockdown. I guess we have been in lockdown for too long now. Nevertheless, we make mistakes, for human is to err. So we continue with these reminders.
And Imam Malik rahimahullah was one of the greatest to have ever taught the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after the galaxy of the Sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in.
Just before the month of Ramadan, to inspire one another to try to do as many good deeds as possible.
This part of the hadith is what we discussed today. So the Prophet ﷺ is reported to have said that when the month of Ramadan comes, the doors of mercy are opened. Not one door, but the doors. There's a multitude of doors. So the ulama,
the one who leaves behind, he abandons and he disowns that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made,
you know, haram, our abilities to cut down on some of those things. So by the time the month of Ramadan comes, that one month can be spent exclusively in the worship of Allah.
Daily salats, from one salat to the next salat, the jumu'ahs, from one jumu'ah to the next jumu'ah, Fridays, and from one Ramadan to the next Ramadan. These are all in atonement. These are all in expiation for a person's sins, as long as that person refrains from committing the major sins.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim nahmaduhu wa nusalli ala rasulihil karim amma ba'd. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back to the countdown. We continue inshallah just before the month of Ramadan to inspire one another to try to do as many good deeds as possible inshallah before now in the month of Ramadan, so that when the month of Ramadan finally comes, like we've been saying every single day, inshallah we can make the best of it. But I'm coming to realize now that a 3-minute, 4-minute, 5-minute reminder every day. I know, unfortunately, we may have the time, but it's a little difficult to just, to tune in and to listen to. But there's actually so much that needs to be shared. For instance, yesterday we spoke about the remembrance of Allah, the dhikr of Allah. There is much more to it than just the few ahadith that we spoke about yesterday. And today, in today's episode, we speak about Ramadan being the month of Duaa, the month of Duaa. Not just the month of Ramadan, but every day in the life of a believer should be Duaa. Duaa is an extremely important worship. In one hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, "Ad-du'a umukhul ibadah." Duaa is the essence of worship. In another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, "Ad-du'a huwa al-ibadah." Dua itself is indeed worship. And then he read the verse of the Holy Quran in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ دُعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِرِينَ. Allah said, and your Rabb has said, call upon me and I shall answer you. Surely those who are too proud to worship, which in this context means those who are too proud to supplicate to Allah, to make dua to Allah, shortly they will enter hell disgraced. Dua is a very serious worship in the life of a believer. In another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, Abdullah radiallahu anhu narrates the hadith of Imam Tirmidhi rahimahullah, Salullah min fadli, ask Allah for his bounties. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلْ يُحِبُّ أَنْ يُسْأَلْ. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes to be asked. And وَأَفْضَلُ الْعِبَادَةِ انْتِظَارُ الْفَرَجِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then said, the most excellent worship is expecting relief as a result of making that dua, hoping that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will find a way out of distress. Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will find a relief from grief after dua has been made. In the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reported to have said, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. Allah says, and when my slave asks you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, concerning me, then answer them that I am indeed near. I answer the dua of the supplicant when he calls me in dua. So there's so many virtues to making dua. And in all honesty, as a reminder for myself and my brothers and sisters, how many of us take out time every day exclusively to make dua? and ask Allah for everything and everything, and speak to Allah, communicate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, apart from the few minutes that we take after Salat, which is an excellent time to be making dua, like we've mentioned in another episode. But to make an exclusive dua every single day, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for us. Ameen. Stay tuned. We'll continue tomorrow, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.